Hello, and welcome to the second episode of RDS Plays, a Game of Thrones LCG second edition. And I promise we will look into finding a shorter title for that. As ever, I am Andy Jones, and I'm here joined by my good pal, Richard Smith.
Hello. So,
we will be playing a Game of Thrones LCG second edition for the second time. We've got the first video up, which you can go and check out, or if you've not don't know the game, you go find our review, which is also on this channel. So if you want to do that, pause it right now, go check, come back. Ready? Perfect. So I am playing on the white play mat here. I'm House Greyjoy, and I'm playing with the Fealty agenda. And I'm playing against
me, Richard, on the beautiful blue Starfield playmat. I've got a lovely little Tyrell Lords of the Crossing.
Lovely. So, I think let's jump straight into this.
Do it.
By cutting the decks. And I'll try not to slam the cards on the table, which causes an echo, apparently.
Right.
As ever, we're going to try and communicate what we're doing and chat about the game as we play. But while there is counting involved,
it's just hard.
There will.
It's tricky, isn't it?
There'll be pauses.
Right. Oh, this is.
Do you know what? I think I'm going to mulligan. I've got a lot of characters here. A lot of characters. But too many. There's no econ.
So, yeah, I think I'm going to do the same, but this is what I have. Like, yeah, great. One of these, perfect.
They are. But I can put her down. Characters.
I mean, like, if I can put her down, survive through the phase, and then use her effect to get the other stuff. But
yeah, fine. But jeez, it's a tough one. So again, we'll be mulliganing, which allows us one opportunity to shuffle and redraw.
Watch as I now pull terrible cards and never see those characters until the end of the game.
Apologies if you're incredibly familiar with the game and my little rules explanations are annoying, but we're trying to not only show a great game but also encourage people not players of the game to come and play. So there will be at times bits where I just talk. I'm going to cut Richard's deck.
Little shallow cut.
Oh, yeah. I went for a deep one, you went shallow. Let's see which one is going to work. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ken, counting. It's difficult. Ooh. Ooh.
Oh no. Okay.
Let's look at what my cards are again and see what. So we've got 8 gold to begin with.
We do, indeed.
I think I'm going to go. I've got to go for this one. And hope for the best. So it's tough. So I'm going to start with Balon Greyjoy. And the Iron Throne.
I've got Wardens of the Reach and the Arbor.
Ooh. Getting that high econ out early.
Yeah, that was. Could have been better, but
it's still a strong.
Yeah, you can't sniff at econ.
So we've drawn back up, and now we'll go into our first phase. Is it phase? First round?
First round. First. This is the first phase of the first round.
Thingamabob.
Yeah.
Using all the technical terms.
Probably.
So let's reveal.
Have I just made a mistake? No.
Okay, cool. So I'm going for heads on spikes.
Go for noble cause.
I've got initiative 6, so I'm going to go first. And I'm hoping.
It's not what you were looking for, is it?
Wasn't. I was looking for a person. But let's go with it. So we'll go to the draw phase. Those are some good draws for me. Okay, so I'm going to take my gold and begin.
Go for it.
2, 3, 4. First thing I'm going to do is jeep up Bowling Greyjoy.
Important.
I'm going to play Sea Tower. Interesting story, the Sea Tower. Didn't have any in my deck when I looked at it this morning.
Brilliant.
I don't know why I didn't have... Sea Tower reduces the cost of cards by one, and it's just a beautiful little card, and I wasn't playing it. Like an idiot.
Had you taken this out then? Because I thought you had Sea Towers in there before.
I have no idea.
Well, doesn't matter. It's in there now. It's the important thing.
Unless I've got six in there, in which case that would be a horrible mistake.
I'm all right with that, to be honest. You can have six of them clogging your deck, making sure you don't pull a Euron.
Maybe I have not. I can't. Well, that's hilarious if that is the case. So I've got four. Potentially get six if needed, which is nice. So I'm going to go... I'm going to kneel the Sea Tower and bring out Asher for four. And I'm going to pass to you.
Brilliant. Okay, I've got just more gold than I know what to do with. So five from there, plus the three from the Arbor gives me eight. Which is beautiful.
And that's why you like the Arbor, isn't it?
Well, I'm trying it out. Don't know if I like it. First thing, Rose Garden. Kneel that, play a Garden Keurtig. And I'm going to kneel him and pay four to play Sir Harbour Redwine. After I marshal him, I'm going to search my deck for a lady character.
Ooh. This is going well. Can I guess which lady it's going to be?
You probably can.
Do you have to reveal it?
Yes, I do. It's the Queen of Thorns.
Ooh, I was going to say Old Marge, but I imagine...
Yeah, well, what I've just done is made a mistake with my maths. So, she's not going to come out this turn, is she?
That's fine, you can set her up for next turn, and I don't have intrigue to...
But it means that I've wasted my beautiful noble cause. Smashing.
Oh, no.
Just top form for me right now. But that's okay. Just freeze up gold to use elsewhere. Okay, I'm going to pay two to play the Arbor Knight. I'm going to pay two to give him a lovely little Meyrin Heat.
Wow. Can you remind me what Meyrin Heat does, Richard?
I can. It's attachment for 9 characters only. When attached character is attacking or defending alone, Meyrin Heat gains action. Kneel Meyrin Heat to choose a participating character with strength higher than that of the attached character and remove that character from the challenge.
Interesting.
Yeah. Especially given that you got Balon on the board.
That's to say, you can really mess me up there, can't you?
Yup.
Interesting.
Anyway, yes, that's me all done, so
apologies.
I will pass to you.
Well, that's changed what I was going to do, actually, so that's really interesting. Okay, cool. What I'm going to do is...
Oh, sorry. Did I shuffle my deck after I did this? I don't think I did. Do that now, whilst you're...
Having a think. I can't do that. Could do that, but then that's a... You know what? Let's just do it anyway. I'm going to do a military challenge with Asher, stealthing past the Arbor Knight.
Makes sense. So she's four.
Strength four.
Okay. really annoying. She stands if it's an opposed, right?
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to block with Wardens of the Reach. Lovely. Their strength 4 as well. We still win. Cool. My claim will be the Garden of Gatsby.
Lovely. And then I'll pass to you.
Brilliant. I'm going to do a military challenge with the Arbor Knight.
Cool. I'm going to block with...
Oh, sorry. Can't do it with the Arbor Knight because they would be minus 1. We'll do a power challenge with Sir Hopper Redwine.
Why would they be minus 1?
From Lord of the Crossing.
Oh, yeah.
So I'll do a power challenge with Sir Hopper Redway.
Power challenge shall opposed.
Cool. Get the unopposed bonus. And I'll do a military challenge with the Arbor Knight.
Unopposed.
Okay, cool.
Ah, of course.
So I'm going to take Asha Greyjoy and give her Risen from the Sea. So she's now strength 5.
Lovely. Chuffed. Delightful. Pleased for you. That's good. That's good.
Thanks.
Okay, and then I'm gonna pass.
Lovely.
And
dominance.
You win dominance. Yeah. By a country mile, you win dominance.
And then reset. An interesting tight first round.
Yeah, I just can't believe I completely misplayed noble cause. So annoying.
That is, I can imagine, frustrating.
What to do? Let's do that.
We go for it. Sneak attack.
Come over Westeros.
Ooh.
Oh, that's... Oh, no. Oh, that's a shame. I'm going to take... Choose... Well, sorry. You've got initiative.
So I'm going to go first. Anyway, I'll let you choose.
I'm going to choose military.
That's a solid choice. Good times. That was a bad misplay by me. Let's go to the draw phase. Okay, so I'm going to take my 5 coins. And in a stroke of luck, I'm going to trip Bell and Greyjoy.
Triple.
So that's quite nice. I'm going to play the Sea Tower. And then I'm going to kneel both the Sea Towers and bring out Euron Crow's Eye.
Ah, that.
Spoke love.
That guy.
5. And I'm going to pass to you.
Cool. Okay, so I've got 5 plus 3 from the Arbor. 8. First of all, I'm going to play a pleasure barge.
Lovely.
Draw 3 cards. Yeah. If you've not yet drawn any cards this phase, draw 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Right, I'm going to play a rose garden. 4-3. I am going to... Yeah, I need to... Dupe up the Arbor. Reason being, I'm worried about losing an intrigue challenge to Euron and you stealing that. And then, what I'm going to do is. How much have I got left? All of it. All of the money. I'm going to kneel the Rose Garden and. Well, both my Rose Gardens. And play High Garden for 1. High Garden challenges action. Kneel High Garden and pay 1 gold to choose an attacking character. Stand that character and remove it from the challenge.
Ooh.
That's
stopping me in my tracks, isn't it?
That's the plan. We'll see just how well that gets on. I'm going to pay 1 to give Heartsbane to Wardens of the Reach.
Wowza.
So they're now looking pretty juicy. And I'm going to pay... Yeah, because I'm worried about... Oh, I've made terrible mistakes. Never mind. It's all in the spirit of good fun. Pay 1 to give a bodyguard to Sir Hubbard Redwine. I'm going to pass to you.
Okay. So, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a power challenge with these two. For a total of 11.
That's a lot.
It is.
You've got pillage on him, but I'm not going to get up to it. I've got on Wardens of the Reach 3, 4, 5, 6 plus 9, so I could win. No, I'm going to pass. So it's unopposed.
Lovely. So I'm going to take my unopposed bonus. I'm going to claim these two.
Go for it.
I'm then going to gain renown for this guy. And then pillage.
Lanner's informant.
Is there any locations in your discard pile?
No.
Okay, and he's going to gain renown as well. And I'll pass to you.
Okay. First of all, I'm going to pay 3 gold.
Yep.
To give the Arbonite 3 strength. I'm just going to put those on there.
Lovely.
So he's now strength 4. I'm going to do a military attack with the Arbonite.
Lovely. That is unopposed.
Brilliant.
I'm going to choose Yoren's Cry.
Yep. Smash him.
He's going to rise from the sea.
Oh, sorry. So that would have been strength 3. Sorry, because of the Lord of the Crossing, if that changes anything. Probably not.
Nope.
I'm now going to do a... Sorry, we're getting there. Just made silly mistakes all over the place today.
You wanted to use Saver for an intrigue, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. Didn't do that, because I could have got all 3 and trigger this. Right, I'm going to do a power challenge with Wardens of the Reach, strength 6.
Strength 6?
Oh, yeah, I've got 3 reach locations.
Oh, because of Heartsbeat.
No, just because of the reach locations. He gets plus 1 strength for each reach location you control.
Oh, wow. I'm going to block so it's not unopposed.
Okay.
But then you can...
So that's currently... So it's used 5. I've got 6. Boost that to... Okay, cool. Yeah, I'll take the single solitary power token. Oh, misplays all over the place. Okay. Dominance, I've got 6, you've got 8.
So I shall win. Let's reset this board. Let's do cards. Fine.
Oh, yeah. Well under.
Choosing the plots is probably one of the most challenging parts of this game because the timing can kind of be everything. For example, if you play a sneak attack hoping to kill lots of characters and your opponent plays Calm of Westeros.
You've got a juicy amount of power.
Yeah, it's alright.
Okay, great.
Let's go. Summons.
Jousting contest.
Ooh. So you've got initiative.
I do. You're going to go first, though.
Yes.
Oh. Yeah. Probably made a mistake there. It's fine. You can go first.
So I'm going to do summons.
Oh, sorry.
What does jousting contest do?
Each player cannot declare more than one character as an attacker or defender each phase.
Lovely.
Each challenge.
Right, so I'm going to go for the reader.
Nice.
Which is a fun one. Have a quick shuffle. Hopefully I can afford to get him out. Okay. So we go to the draw phase.
Two cards.
Let's see. Finally. Finally. Prize. So I've got four. I'm going to bring out a Rose Road.
Nice.
Start things going. And I'm one short of what I want to do. That's fine. So I'm going to pay. Going to tap both sea towers, and for one, bring out the Great Kraken.
Remember what? Oh, that's the.
So Balon gets stealth.
Lovely.
And also, after I win an unopposed challenge, I can either draw one card or gain one power.
Brilliant.
And then I'm also going to pay three to bring out my Black Winds crew.
Nice.
And then pass to you.
Brilliant. Okay, so I have. 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, that minus one for the pleasure barge doesn't seem so bad once you get the got the arbor out, does it?
No, not really. Right. Okay, first of all, I'll kneel both of these to give Harbour red wine, lovely little Marin Heat.
Ah.
So then I've got three left, so I'm going to pay three to play the Manda, another reach location. Reaction after you win a challenge by five or more strength, kneel the Manda to draw two cards.
Lovely.
And then I'm going to pass.
Okay. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do an intrigue with Yoren Crozai.
Okay, I'm going to kneel Highgarden and pay one gold to remove him from the challenge and stand him.
Lovely. See, now I think we're going to have a problem. So I'm going to do a power challenge. Stealthing past Hobber Red Wine.
Okay, I'm going to kneel Wardens of the Reach to block.
Cool.
Which is strength 7, as it is now.
7. So that means I cannot do anything about that. Which is interesting. So my final challenge is going to have to be with Balon Greyjoy. It's going to be military. Stealthing past. Hobber Red One.
Okay, it's unopposed.
Unopposed. So I'm going to take one coin for that. One power for that, sorry. We'll do claim.
Take the bodyguard off Hobber.
Lovely. We're going to gain renown. And then also, I'm going to draw a card due to the Great Kraken.
Lovely.
Oh. And then I'm going to pass to you.
Okay, I'm going to do a strength 3 power challenge.
Lovely, I'm going to block with Urine's Cry. Total of 7.
I'm going to do an intrigue challenge with the Arbor Knight.
Ooh, see.
Oh, sorry. Oh, yeah, sorry. You got pillage. And
so pillage, I've got renown and then pillage.
Course down the rose, still no locations. No.
Perfect. Okay, sorry.
Yeah, okay. Sure, so I'm doing my intrigue with Arbonite.
Lovely. I'm just gonna shuffle these in case you know what you think you know where the good card is.
Get rid of the Hand's Judgment.
Which is
pretty timely because I'm now going to play Tears of the Lease.
Ooh.
And we'll put that on Asher.
Wowzer.
In the hope that you don't have yet, well, your third copy of Risen from the Sea.
Whew. And that's awkward because I could have used Hand's Judgment there to Actually, I couldn't because it's cost. I don't have any. Okay.
Cool. So, and then that's me done.
End of the phase. Asher will unfortunately terminate.
Prison of the Sea, is that terminal?
It's. Well, as a condition attachment. It's not, but it's an event.
Ah, okay. Yep.
So, it goes away.
Cool.
We go to dominance.
You win.
Which I win. And then we reset the board. That was a tough loss for me, but interesting you didn't go for Balon.
Well, you've got dupes on him.
Is it not? Is it just a one? It's not a burning.
Yeah, remove it and kill that character so you can.
He picked one and then he went back.
I'm not sure what I want to be doing. Okay. Make a decision. You got to make a decision. Let's do this.
You ready?
Yep.
Let's go. Got a Clash of Kings.
Building Orders.
What does Building Orders do, Richard?
I'm going to search the top 10 cards of my deck for an attachment or a location, reveal it and add it to my hand.
Lovely. Oh, we'll let you do that. I'm going to go first.
Cool.
However, and I play the Clash of Kings, which allows me an additional power if I win. Also works on defending, which is quite nice.
Attachment allocation, look at the puppy.
Ooh, that's not a good one. It's not a good one for me. But that's fine. If you do it on. Who are you going to do it on? You're on a Balon.
I don't know which one's worse.
Balon will still have stealth because he gets that from this warship. But Euron's ability to pillage a location can be useful. Not that we've seen anything like that occur yet.
But we won't take stealth off Balon because that's from Great Kraken.
That's literally what I just said.
Sorry.
It will mean anyone can block him though, which is something he does not enjoy.
No, not a fan of that, is he?
So we're going to draw phase. Which is the interesting bit. So I'm going to gain my 5 gold now. That's okay with you,
I suppose.
Can you just talk me through your locations quickly?
Yep, got the Manda. After you win a challenge by 5 or more strength, kneel the Manda to draw 2 cards.
Yep.
High Garden, kneel High Garden, pay 1 gold to choose an attacking character, stand that character and remove it from the challenge. 2 Rose Gardens, the Arbor, and Pleasure Barge.
Lovely jubbly.
If you're looking at newly made lord, which I would guess that you are.
I am indeed.
Well, there's one that I would definitely get rid of if I was you.
I think it's High Garden, isn't it? That's the.
Who can say?
Or is it the Pleasure Barge? What's Pleasure Barge?
Pleasure Barge is immune to card effects, but it doesn't give me any benefits anymore.
Interesting. Well, first of all, I'm going to play a second Rose Rage. That's going to be the key to winning this for me. Then I'm going to play the 2 Sea Towers, and for 3, bring out the Reader.
Nice.
And then I'm going to pay 2 for a Raiding Longship, which if I'm the first player, I can kneel to choose a defending character without attachments, which is not so helpful at the moment, but that character does not contribute its strength to the challenge.
Pretty good. Pretty good.
And then I pass to you.
Okay, cool. So, making space there. I've got
making space for all the gold coins I'm about to get.
I only get 6. It's not as many as I had before.
I'm sorry. It's so bad for you.
It's terrible. Yeah. I'm gonna nail both of these.
Yep.
And finally play Queen of Thorns.
Oh, she's out. Shaking it all about.
Is that right? Yeah, now those two I should be paying 5, which is what I've got in my hand. Perfect. And then.
I wonder what that last coin could be used for.
Well, that's what I'm thinking. I think I'm better to hold it back for the time being.
Oh, really?
I'll pass.
Interesting. Okay, cool. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a... What am I going to do? That's the real question. So does the Queen of Thorns activate on a defense?
If she wins a challenge.
Interesting.
So attack or defense.
So if I just casually bring in the reader, that is an issue.
Probably.
Let's do it anyway. Let's see what happens. I'm going to do an intrigue with the reader.
Cool. I'm going to block with the Harbour Knight.
Lovely.
I'm going to kneel Marin He to remove the reader from the challenge.
Okay. Cool. How does that work? Does he stand or is he just...
No, he's just removed from the challenge, I think. Yeah, to choose a participating character with strength higher than that of the attached character and remove that character from the challenge.
Cool. Okay, I'm going to do a military challenge with Bell and Greyjoy, sneaking pass, stealthing pass, so hold the red one.
What strength is Bell on at the moment?
He's still 5.
Oh, 5 plus 1, so strength 6.
Why is he plus 1?
I thought you...
Sorry.
You're not fished him out, so yeah, that's your run. So, power challenge.
Yep. Military challenge.
Military challenge? Well, that's one that I should probably be trying to block then, isn't it?
Potentially.
Right, okay. Sorry, I'm just debating how to do it. Okay, I'll block with Wardens of the Reach.
Cool. I'm going to kneel Raiden Longship so that strength doesn't contribute to the challenge.
I thought that was without attachments.
That is upsetting. That's real upsetting because you've got strength 400, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Strength 7.
Lovely. That means you've won, and there's nothing I can do about that. I've made a mistake, viewers, and this is not... It's not going to go well. I could do that. Is that going to work? You've got 9. Oh yeah, okay, so I'm going to do a power challenge with your own Crozo. Strength 7.
Cool, I'm going to block with Hubba Red One. And then I'm going to kneel Marin Heat to remove your arm from the challenge.
I can't do anything.
Now you know what I feel like when you play Greyjoy.
That is frustrating. Okay, cool. Is it just kneel or just discard?
That's a good point. Just kneel. Crazy.
Powerful. Cool, and then I pass.
Okay, I'm going to do a intrigue with Queen of... I've got to do it. It's the only thing I've got available. Strength 5.
Cool. And I post.
Okay, let's do that one. That wasn't strength 5, sorry, it was strength 4, but still.
That's fine.
Okay.
Lost new main lord, which is a good card.
Yeah, which is good. That's the card there. So, Queen of Thorns. Then I'm going to bring in...
Oh, you got an unopposed bonus as well.
Sorry.
So that was my fault. I offered my cards too early.
I'm going to put down the Knight of Flowers.
Lovely.
Perfect.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to swing out with a power challenge. Strength 5.
I guess he comes into play straight away, doesn't he? That's nice. So I'm going to block with the Black Winds crew, but you win.
Yep. Cool, so I get one of your powers.
Yep.
He gains power through renown. Should have done that earlier, but didn't. And that's it, I will pass. You win dominance.
Get a lovely dominance bonus. Cool. These Meryn Heats are very upsetting.
Good.
Let's go all out. I'm ready to go straight away. Exactly what I want to play.
Know what you're doing, do you?
Do indeed. Hashtag bringing the noise. Hopefully. Yeah. Ready? Calling the manners.
Calling the manners. That's interesting.
Yeah, okay, cool.
So, power-wise, I have less.
Yep.
So, I'm going to go... Raiding Longship, is that, does that only work if you're the first player?
Yes.
Cool. I'm going to go first.
Okay, I'll pass that to you. I'm just going to nail Raiding Longship purely so we...
Yep, so we keep track of it.
Yep.
And then we might as well take our coins.
Yep.
So I get 4 off you.
I get 5 off you.
Lovely.
It's a delight. Let's go to the draw phase. Because I need cards so badly.
Okay. Okay, right, so then I gain 3 plus 2. I'm going to pay... First of all, I'm going to pay 1 to give the reader Milk the Poppy.
Lovely. Let me just see if I can't block that. I don't think I can. Yep.
I'm going to dupe up the Queen of Thorns.
I think this is what we call the turning point for me.
I pay 1. In fact, no. Kneel a Rose Garden to play Garden Caretaker.
Obviously.
And I will kneel the other Rose Garden to play Sir Horace Red Wine for 4. Yep.
Lovely. My go?
Yep, sorry, I passed to you.
So I get 5. 4, 5. And just gonna pay 4 to bring out Fionn.
There he is.
And then I don't have any cards that I can use money for, so I pass.
Okay.
Does Meryn Heat work when attacking?
Yeah, if the character is attacking or defending alone.
Interesting.
Which is...
alone?
Yes.
Ooh.
Yeah, so it's... that's what I need to sort out.
Yeah.
I could really do one with one on Knight of Flowers. That would be quite nice, but... Gave them to these two chumps, didn't I?
I suppose I don't think the terminal, are they? So... Just kill the other knight and then...
I don't want to do that. He's a good chap. It's the other night.
One strength.
Exactly.
It's all about survival in my kingdom.
Speaking of survival, let's do this. Let's do a military challenge with Wardens of the Reach, which is strength 7.
Interesting. Okay, cool. I'm going to block with Yorin's Crow Eye and the Black Wind Screw for a total of 10.
Cool. I'm going to kneel Heartsbane to boost him up to strength 10. Oh no, sorry, that's not, is it? Because that should be minus 1 from Lords of the Crossing. So actually, initially it was only 6. So whether you just want to block with Euron.
Now I know you're going to do that. If I don't, though, we've got into a sort of paradoxical cycle. I'm going to leave it as it is.
Cool. So that's 10, and I can get up to 9. So yeah. We'll leave that as it is.
Okay, perfect. So I will do pillage twice.
Oh yeah, dang. Randy, and Courtesan of the Rose. Still don't think I've got any locations in here, though.
That is upsetting for me.
Okay. Okay, right, so... So I did the military there. Sorry, I'm just trying to work out the best way to do this.
That's fine. I shall entertain the viewers while we wait.
Okay, I'm going to do...
I'm not sure how.
...a intrigue with the Arbor Knight. Current strength is 1.
That will come through... unopposed.
Okay.
You get your unopposed bonus as well.
Yes.
Hand's Judgment. That's a tough one to lose.
Okay, and then... So, I've now got +2 for each character.
Yep.
We're talking power.
Queen of Thorns only activates on an intrigue, though.
Yes.
Which is...
I'm well aware, unfortunately.
Grateful for.
Your current potential power is 7. 12. Okay, let's do this. So, 11 plus 6, so 17.
Lovely, unopposed.
Brilliant, okay. So unopposed, claim, I guess we do the thing, the like renown and stuff before we play cards.
I think it's sort of, it's a bit... I think play cards and then do...
Cool, if you're happy for me to play.
Yeah.
I've got to support the people, so we're going to pay one to play that. Search for a printed location, a location with printed cost 3 or less.
Lovely.
And put it into play. Which one do we go for? Let's just do another rose red. And I'm also going to shuffle this. So because I won by 5 or more, I'm going to kneel Amanda.
Yep.
And to draw 2 cards.
Lovely.
Okay. And then I gain a power because of Lord of the Crossing.
Yep.
And I'll pass to you.
Cool. I'm going to do a power challenge. Stealthing past Hobber Red Wine and Horace Red Wine.
Ah, they've both got stealth.
Yeah.
Dang. That's frustrating. Yeah, so it's unopposed then, it looks like.
Lovely, so I gain an unopposed bonus. Cool.
Oh no, is that?
I'll get 1 for you. I'll gain... 1 here, and 1 here. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14.
Oh, God.
And then I get to draw a card, but we go into dominance.
Well, you could have done your intrigue as well, an opposed intrigue.
Oh, yeah.
So stupid.
But I'm going to pass because I've got 14.
So stupid. So I'd forgotten that they both had stealth. I was going to kneel Horace, which stood her.
Oh, really?
Might be able to take your intrigue.
Nice.
Dang.
That was a close one. A very close one. I think I just sort of scraped by. I think if that had gone a couple more rounds, you could have just eked away at me, killed a couple of my characters, and then I would have been...
Yeah, I think I had a couple of misplays, which messed me thoroughly up.
You got your locations out enough, though, didn't you?
Yeah, that was really, really lucky with those...
So this is the first time you played Tyrell?
The first time I've played this deck.
Pure Tyrell?
At all. And the first time I've played Tyrell in a good long while.
And how did you find the deck?
It's good. It's quite nice, and it's nice being used to playing the Greyjoy so often. to be able to play the same tricks that I'm used to seeing from you. So all of a sudden, oh, you want to knock people out of the challenges? Well, deal with it, because which is pretty lovely. But yeah, it's good, and I know that you love your Greyjoys.
I do indeed. I might change Fealty to Lord of the Crossing though, and then attack with Bale on last, and he's got +2, and then he's pretty much.
Yeah, but I mean that doesn't help against the Tyrell deck. So long as I've got one character.
I've got Irish, but in general.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool, brilliant. Well, so let's end it there. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the game. Do let us know if you've got any comments. And as ever, please like and subscribe for more videos here at Rolling Dice Show. But until next time, definitely start playing Game of Thrones 2nd Edition LCG, because it's amazing and good fun. And good game, Rich.
GG.